Hello guys, it's Sunil Digi here, and today we are going to see about the turn on off and flexible OLED display. So this is the OLED display, guys. So you may have been heard of your OLED displays that are flexible. You may have been watched some videos from CES. They may just see by curving the display, they may show the displays. But actually, you guys may not know that some smartphones that are using curved displays or flexible displays. So I'll just review them up. So this is a display from the LG G Flex 2. So it's really a old smartphone. I lost this phone. It dead around 1 year back. So I just want to reveal what's inside the flexible display. So now let's see. Just having two layers. One is the polarizer and touch digitizer layer that has the chipset to decode the touch screen, multiple capacitive touch screen decoded chip here. I think that's from a Synaptics. And here we got is the OLED panel itself. So actually this was made by LG, and they named this display as an P-OLED panel, plastic OLED display. And this is the OLED area. So this is the display itself. I think it's around 0.01 millimeter thickness. It's really great, guys. Great invention, but we may not even rather think about it. But the display used in the Samsung Galaxy A50 and such displays that are not curved that doesn't have curved edges over the sides or something, they are glass material. Actually, this is a plastic material build. In the earlier days, Samsung do make displays with glass material, and nowadays also they are making for their budget devices. But actually the display used in S10, S8, S9, even the Note 8, Note 9 in Samsung's Galaxy series are also made of plastic AMOLED display, but they won't mention them as a plastic AMOLED display because LG has a patent for that. It's a plastic, they should not name like that. And also LG's display is also a kind of AMOLED display, but they cannot, LG cannot mention this as a plastic AMOLED because AMOLED is a term patented by Samsung, so they cannot do like that. So this is what the mentioning has been done. So Samsung's curved AMOLED, the flexible AMOLED display, you may have been noted that in the recent OnePlus 7 Pro also has Samsung's flexible AMOLED display, and also the smartphone's upcoming S10, Note 10 will also have a flexible display like this. So all these smartphones that have curved edges may use this flexible AMOLED display because they are easily curvable, they are less fragile as compared. So the glass material made displays are really fragile compared to the flexible one because these displays have lots of issues, like the somebody makes a drop test using these kind of smartphones, even from the 8 feet of height, the display also get damaged much easier. But the P-OLED display has an advantage that they are unbreakable. So they can be torn, but they cannot be breaked actually, because they are like a paper, a plastic sheet of paper. So they cannot be breaked even if you try to harm this with a heavy hammer or something. But this kind of glass material made AMOLED displays can be easily breaked off. So that's an advantage for the P-OLED and the plastic material AMOLED displays. So we get different drivers unit for the AMOLED area. This is the OLED area where we get the OLED pixels over here, and they are arranged to the driver IC here, and we get the connector to be connected to the motherboard itself. And this is the polarizer part, we get the driver unit. So other than that, we get a glass here. This is the tempered glass where the AMOLED display actually rests. So to remove that, I use the heat gun to actually remove that safely. And this is the plastic metal body. So this is what is inside the flexible OLED display you can find in the market. So nothing more different. That's it. So thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe my channel for daily updates like this. And also, if you have any doubts regarding the OLED displays, you can surely ask me in the comment section. I will surely reply you. So see you later on another video, guys. Thanks for watching. See you later.